Somebody, I know in between y'all, but touch your mic and say, look at the life reflections. Look at the life reflections. I want to help you real fast. Now, if you had a great life thus far, then God bless you. But there's some stuff that I don't even want to reflect back on in my life. Y'all don't have no church for real. There's some stuff that I don't even want to see no more. There's some stuff that I don't want to be with no more. There's some people that I don't even want to talk to no more. To high five somebody and say, don't put that in my obituary. I'm still here. Come on, somebody. There's some stuff that I want God to do in my life, but it don't need to be wrote down. See, when we're looking at the life reflections, folks, let me tell you, I read this obituary not that long ago, and they had this person talking like he was talking to the people. I don't want that, because I want to tell you something real quick. See, sometimes when you're looking at the life reflections, they talk too much in the reflections. Some people say it gets messy. It gets messy. But let me tell you, life is messy. Because you in it. Y'all don't have a church for real. Because you live in it. That's why it's messy, because we in it. And we sinful, and we filthy, and we shameful, and we do stuff that we ain't supposed to do. Look at your neighbor, your neighbor. God got some greater for me in the parting view. I want to help somebody in your face. See, when we get to, by the time we work our way down, we get past the solo. And I promise, I didn't come to have a funeral today. But some stuff I'm just loving God for, because some stuff in the heaven has got to just die. I don't want to talk to you, but you come up on Memorial Day, a good holiday, and they memorize your stuff. But can I help somebody real fast? Some stuff you don't even need to let be a memory. Because somebody said, I don't even want that to be in my memory Rolodex. I don't even want that conversation remembered. I don't want to just say, you know what? If we get to a place and we get to some folks and we get tired of being sick and tired, and tired of being sick and tired, and folks do gonna do what they want to do anyway, you come to a place where you have to say, you know what? God, just give me peace in the midst of this shock. Lord, just hold me when I get weak along this journey. Lord, I just need you to be a fence around me, Jesus. Lord, close my eyes so I don't see the ignorance stuff that goes on. Lord, come on, somebody. How about your neighbor say, neighbor? We almost to the party. Lot's wife had made her way down. All that sin they was living in Sodom and Gomorrah. Oh, they was doing all kind of stuff. When I was growing up, I thought of that city as being the worst city in the world. My grandfather would get up in history and he would drag that city through the mud. But you know what, church? When I found out in 2017, we're living in that city
that's
right now.
Right, that's right. That's it.
Y'all don't believe it?
Yeah.
They ain't got no business making a unisex bathroom.
That's right.
For folk that want to use the bathroom when they know they're not a man or they know they're not a woman.
Yeah.
Ain't got no business. If you, your business, your business. But I'm going to need you to urinate what you was born with. Y'all don't have no church for real. First, I said, you know what? Let them people do what they want to do. Let them. No, but I don't want that kind of person in the bathroom with my baby.
No.
I'm serious. Because it teaches children something different.
That's right.
See, the life reflections are for us to read when we go to a funeral. But right now, your reflections are for the people that stand watching you, for your kids, and generations to come. See, mama get mistreated, then she gonna be mistreated. If they see mama don't stand for nothing, then she fall for anything. Look at somebody and say, look at me. I'm trying to be a good life reflection. I just want my life reflections to really reflect me.
That's right, that's
look, if I know before any of y'all go in this church, don't put down he found Christ at an early age.
That's right.
Because I didn't know who he was. I had to be at least 25 before I really knew who Jesus was. But that's the story. I just want to tell the truth. Don't no 6-year-old know nothing about how Jesus can pick you up, how Jesus can bring your heart back together, how when the bills are good, Pastor. I found the helper who you all listen. When all man was breaking down. You couldn't get in the church. Mm-hmm. Upstairs, downstairs, basement, outside, nowhere. Mm-hmm. But it made me a little sad. Uh-huh. Because we are rather wait,
baby,
until people,
mm-hmm,
are doing the part in you.
Yeah.
We used to have a straw, you know. Elder Lord, talking about, we will sing hallelujah,
yeah,
and glory,
yeah,
at a funeral, won't we?
Yeah.
But I respect this bishop. He said, I'm not doing my wife's funeral on no weekend, because they bring too many unnecessary Negroes out.
All right.
I've been praying, asking God. Heal this, God fix this, God can do this, and he can. But one thing we have to be careful, when going back in our past, we got to be careful on not leaving stuff to our future. Because see, what we'll do is we're going to try to connect what was with what's now to what's to come.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, yours is already disconnected from today.
That's right.
Y'all should learn that in school. Yours is a past tense.
That's right.
Y'all don't know how to church for real. See, the only problem I have with folks and ladies and gentlemen of the Christian-oriented people, y'all helping me with this, is because we'll go back to what was.
Yes.
Somebody said was. Was your friend.
Yeah.
Not today.
Not today.
He was your boyfriend.
Not today.
Come on, help me preach y'all. He was a good friend of mine. Not today. She was a faithful Christian. Come on, church. I can get out of here. You know what? When it be like three people, you just feel like preaching out. No, let me tell you. They was some good helpers.
Not today.
Somebody said today brings a different story. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, not today. It's totally different from what was. But I come to help somebody. No, today ain't got to stay like this. Because survival is on the way. Look out your neighbors. Lot's wife looked back. She looked back. She didn't look back and turn around and walk back. She looked back mentally.
That's right.
Somebody said, you got to be careful. The devil plays mind games.
Yes, he will.
He will. He will. How you thinking what is and it ain't?
Yeah.
How you thinking something is great and it was? Somebody said, was great. Anybody ever been in a war's relationship?
Yeah.
Somebody said, sometimes you just got to face the fact to what was. It was good.
It was
great at one time.
Yeah.
But today is shaky.
Today is not.
The consistency of people varies. When it comes to the life reflections.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, I've had the privilege of preaching numerous of funeral after funeral after funeral. And it never fails in the life reflections. They say that they had children with this person, and then God blessed them with this marriage and this and this and that. Look, if you have more than three marriages, tell somebody before you die, don't put that in your obituary.
Don't.
Nobody got to read about all your messiness stuff that was.
Yeah,
ain't got to read about you having seven and eight again. It's just know I raised my kids to the best of my ability. That's it. They ain't got to know nothing else. I want to help you real fast. Pastor, how can I keep that to myself? You got to stop talking so much. We got to stop mentioning so much unnecessary stuff.
Yeah.
Because then people won't know the background scriptures to our life.
That's right.
And they won't even have privilege to put it in the life reflections because they don't know it. You know what? The old people used to have a saying, some stuff you keep and tell you that.
That's right.
I want to help you with us. Some stuff you just take to the grave with you. Let it be buried with you. Gotta know all your business just because it happened. I want to help somebody real fast. Because you was a prostitute, don't mean you're a prostitute today. Because you was a whoremonger, don't mean that's what's going on today. You was a backslider, but don't mean it happened today. You let somebody say, I was a prayer, but not today. I was rich like that, but not today. Somebody say, not today, not today. Here we go. We come, and somebody said, not today. That's my saying at work when I get to work and they get on. I said, not today. Today ain't your day. It was yesterday that I was like that. That's not today. See, some of y'all acting like y'all ain't got that little bipolar itch on you. But I know what it is. Some days I see you and I just be the happiest person. Oh, how you doing, beautiful? And the next day, that was yesterday. Today you have done something totally different, and now it ain't the same way it was. Exactly. It ain't the same way.
Exactly.
But look, when we get through the funeral part of our life, and we get to the party view, can I have somebody real fast? It does not matter how many things have got to die in you, as long as you let it be dead. When they get to the party view, somebody said, that's God work right there. That's God work. That's God. You ain't got nothing to do with that past. That was God work. That was God. You ain't got nothing to do with that. Folk be trying to get folk out the casket, rock them, with them, holding them.
Yeah.
And I get that you love them. But the spirit of them is gone.
That's right.
Can I help somebody real fast? Don't try to dig up your past. Go on through that part of you, because the spirit of what was is gone. Somebody said, what was is just what it is. It was. Somebody said, it was. See, I know, because see, look, let me tell you something. When we get to the part of you, so many people want to run around, and some people just want to parade around the church and let folks see them anyway.
Yeah.
Just because you bought a new outfit for that day. Or you got a new hairpiece put in. Look, let me tell you. When we parted in our life, and you walk to the casket of your decisions. You hear what I said? When you walk to the casket
of
your decisions. And God gives you another chance. Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Somebody said, He gives me another chance. Give me another chance. See, when you get to the casket of your mistakes, it's time then for you to say ashes to ashes. Look at your neighbor's name. It's time for you to haul ashes to ashes and dust to dust. Open your mouth in this place and thank God for the party people. the blood.
Yes,
somebody said once.
I know it was. Hey,
let me tell you, it's only one was that's still transcending.
Uh-huh.
Oh, the rest of the was meant to be left in the past.
Yes.
But the blood is. Y'all don't hear me. The blood was. Hallelujah. Same things to the stuff in our life that's dragging us down.
That's right.
When you got a family on life support and you're on a machine, it bothers you. Because now you got to go to the hospital. You got to visit. You got to pray. You got to ask for a miracle. You got to ask God for this. When all God trying to do is heal you, let it go.
That's right.
Somebody said, just let it go.
Just let it go.
That didn't even have to be your problem if you wasn't so busy trying to hang on to what was. And start praising God for what is. And what is still yet to come. Somebody say, greater is coming.
Greater.
Even if I'm living in the worst of my life, greater is coming. So I'm asking you today to put a mandate over your situation. Stuff that you can't control no way. And do a parting view. Look at your neighbors and neighbor.
It's time.
For the party view. Let's give just a hand praise to this place. Hallelujah. Those are churches open. If you need a church home.